Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the Geyer Performing Arts Center for tonight's production of A Miracle Worker. Please take this opportunity to turn off all cell phones and pagers. Take note of the emergency exits in the front and rear of the auditorium. Due to copyright infringement laws, please refrain from audio and video recordings. Join us for our next production of Beauty and the Beast, Junior, June 17th and 18th. And Disney's Beauty and the Beast, June 22nd through 25th. The Geyer Performing Arts Center is proud to offer this production as our way of celebrating the 100th anniversary of Lions Clubs International in conjunction with the PA Lions State Convention. We welcome all the Lions from across Pennsylvania who join us for this production. We humbly thank all of the Lions who volunteer here at our theater and throughout the community. Now sit back, relax, and enjoy our production of A Miracle Worker, directed by Lion Cat Post and Victoria Post.
Children.
Thank God.
You're a pair of lucky parents. I can tell you now, I thought she wouldn't.
Oh, nonsense. The child's a killer. She has the constitution of a goat. She will outlive us all.
Yes, especially if some of you Kellers don't get a good night's sleep. I mean you, Mrs. Keller.
I hear.
I brought up two of them. This is my wife's first. She isn't battle scarred yet.
Doctor, don't be merely considerate. Will my girl be all right?
By morning, she'll be knocking down Captain Keller's fences again.
And isn't there anything we should do?
Put up stronger fences, huh?
Just let her get well. She knows how to do it better than we do. These things come and go in infants. Main thing is the fever's gone. Call it acute congestion of the stomach and brain.
I'll see you to your buggy, Doctor.
I've never seen a baby more vitality, that's the truth.
Hush, don't you cry now. You've been troubled enough. Call it acute congestion. I don't see what's so cute about congestion just because it's yours. We'll have your father run an editorial in this paper about the wonders of modern medicine. They don't know what they're curing, even when they cure it. Men and their battle scars. We women will have to... We'll have to... Helen. Captain, will you come? Captain!
Katie!
Captain!
Katie! What's wrong?
Look!
What, Katie? She's well. She needs only time.
Oh, she can't see. Look at her eyes. She can't see.
Helen.
Or hear. When I screamed, she didn't blink, not an eyelash.
Helen.
She can't hear you.
Helen!
Bite her hand?
That's how I do. She keep poking her fingers in my mouth, I just bite them off.
What's she trying to do now?
She's trying to talk. She's gonna get mad. Look at her trying to talk.
Hey, stop that!
Suggestion. What?
Why, that famous Oculus in Baltimore.
notes, Ma, that I wrote you about. What was his name?
Oh, Dr. Chisholm.
Yes. I've heard there's cases of blindness. They said could never be cured, that he has cured. Now, Arthur, why don't you write to him?
I'll stop believing in all those wonders.
I think the captain will write to him soon, won't you, Captain?
No.
Good money after bad, or bad after good, or bad after bad.
If it's a question of money, now, Arthur, you're the marshal. You've got all that Yankee money. You might as well...
It's not money. The child's been the specialist all over Alabama and Tennessee. If I thought it would do good, I'd have it every fool doctor in the country.
I think the captain will write to him soon.
Kitty, how many times can you let them break your heart?
Any number of times.
Oh, what, child, what?
As long as there's the least chance for her to see or hear.
There isn't.
I think, with your permission, Captain, I'd like to write.
I said no, Kitty.
Well, there's no harm in writing a little bitty letter. I mean, just to see if the man can help her.
He can't.
We won't know that to be a fact until after you write, Captain.
Kitty! He can't.
Woo! Father stands up. That makes it a fact.
Keep quiet. Imagine enough of you by females without your impudence. Kitty. Might as well try to look in her hand, you ought as in this house.
You really ought to put her away, Father.
What?
Some asylum. It's the kindest thing.
James, she is your sister, not a noble.
Half-sister. And half mentally defective. She can't even keep herself clean. It's not pleasant to see her about all the time.
Do you dare complain of what you can see?
This discussion is at an end. I thank you not to broach it again, Ev. I've done as much as I can bear. I can't give my whole life to it. The house is at sixes and sevens from morning to night over the child. It's time some attention was paid to Mildred here instead.
You'll wake him, Captain.
I want some peace in the house. I don't care how. But one way we won't have it is by rushing up and down the country every time somebody hears of a new quack. I'm as sensible to this affliction as anyone else. It hurts me to look at the girl.
It was not our affliction I meant for you to write about, Captain.
Oh, Helen, my buttons!
Oh. Eyes? She wants the doll to have eyes.
Oh, Kate, I'm not decent. Goodness gracious.
Oh, she doesn't know better, Anna. I've often sewed them on again.
Oh, never learn with everyone. Letting her do anything, you
be quiet.
Oh, what I say now?
You talk too much.
I was agreeing with you.
Whatever it was. Deprived child. The least she can have are the little things she wants.
Oh, look, Kate. It was worth a couple of buttons. I mean, this child has more sense than all these Mankellers. If ever there was a way we could reach that mind of hers.
Helen!
Helen! You are not to do such things! How can I make you understand? How can I get it into your head?
My darling, my poor...
Some way of teaching her an iota of discipline has.
How can you discipline an afflicted child? Is it her fault?
I didn't say it was her fault.
Then whose? I don't know what to do. How can I teach her? Beat her until she's black and blue?
It's not safe to let her run around loose. Now there must be a way of confining her somehow.
Where? In a cage? She's a growing child. She has to use her limbs.
Is it fair to Mildred here?
Are you willing to put her away?
Oh, what now?
She wants to talk, be like you and me. Every day she slips further away, and I don't know how I can call her back.
Oh, I've a notion to take her to Baltimore myself. If that doctor can't help her, maybe he'll know someone who can.
looking for the girl, of course. It was Dr. Bell who thought that somehow she might be taught. I've written to the family only that a suitable governess, Miss Annie Sullivan, has been found here in Boston and will come. So, this is the last time I will counsel you. And I know it will be difficult for you down there. It's been difficult for you here at the school, too, yes. Gratifying, but to have come to us, not able to spell your own name, and to have accomplished so much in a few years, but always with that same Irish battle for independence. This is the last time I counsel you, and you still lack some. By some, I mean all of what? Tact? The talent to bend to other people? Your eyes hurt.
My ears, Mr. Ominous.
And what? There is nowhere to send you but back to Tewksbury where they teach children to be saucy. No. Always the same Irish battle for independence. You must realize that battle is dead and done with. Why not let it stay buried?
I think God must owe me a resurrection.
What?
Well, he keeps digging up that battle.
That is not a proper thing to say. It was what I mean.
Yes, but I know what I'm like. What's this child like?
Like?
Well, bright or dull to start off.
Who knows? But if she is dull, you have no patience with this?
Oh, in grown-ups, you have to, Mr. Ominous. I mean, in children, it just seems a little precocious. Can I use that word?
Only if you can spell it.
Premature. So I hope at least she's a bright one.
Deaf, blind, mute. She is like a little safe that is locked, that no one can open. Perhaps there's a treasure inside.
Maybe it's empty, too?
Possible. But I must warn you, she is much given to tantrums.
Means something's inside. Well, so am I. If I believe all I hear, maybe you should warn them.
No, I wrote them nothing of your history, Annie. You will be among strangers now who know nothing of it.
Well, we'll keep them in a state of blessed ignorance.
Perhaps you should tell it.
Why? I have enough trouble with people who don't know.
So they will understand when you have trouble.
The only time I have trouble is when I'm right. Is it my fault it's so often? I won't give him any trouble, Mr. Ananos. I'll be so ladylike he won't notice I've come.
Annie, please be humble. It's not as though you have so many opportunities to pick and choose from. You will need their affection if you were to work with this girl.
I hope I won't need their pity.
We can all use pity. So, you are no longer a pupil. We send you out into the world a teacher, if she can be taught. So, no one expects miracles of you, Annie, even for $25 a month. In this envelope, a loan for the railroad, which you will repay me when you have a banking account. In this box, a gift with our love. Now, there are other friends who are ready to say goodbye.
Mr. Ananos. Dear Mr. Ananos, Well, what should I say? I'm an ignorant, opinionated girl, and everything I am I owe to you?
That is only half true, Annie.
Which half? I crawled in here like a drowned rat. I thought I died when Jimmy died, that I'd never again come alive. Well, you say with love so easy, and I haven't loved a soul since, and never will, I suppose. But this place gave me more than my eyes back. Or taught me how to spell, which I'll never learn anyway. But with all the fights and trouble I've been here, it taught me what help is and how to live again. I don't want to say goodbye. Don't open the door.
No, they will not see.
Annie!
Here, Amelia.
There's a present. We thought you were going away, President.
Oh, now you shouldn't have.
Oh, we did.
Don't go, Annie. Away. Oh, they feel just fine.
My eyes feel hundreds of percent better already. And pretty. Why, do you know how I look in them? Splendiloquent. Like a racehorse.
There's another present, Annie. We brought another present for Helen, too.
Give it to her, Beatrice.
Here, Annie.
It's for Helen. And we took it for collection to buy it.
And Laura dressed it.
It's beautiful.
So don't forget, you be sure to give it to Helen from us, Annie.
I promise it will be the first thing I give her. If I don't keep it for myself, that is. You know I can't be trusted with dolls.
Don't go, Annie, to her.
Sarah, dear, I don't want to go. I'm a big girl now, and big girls have to earn a living. It's the only way I can. But if you don't smile for me first, what I'll just have to do is...
What?
Put you in my suitcase instead of this doll, and take you to Helen in Alabama.
Now, come, children. We must get the trunk to the carriage, Annie to the train, or no one goes to Alabama. Come.
Sullivan, age 9, virtually blind. James Sullivan, age 7. What's the matter with your leg, Sonny?
Forever and ever.
Can't you walk without that limp? Girls in the women's
hey,
course,
Annie,
boys in the men's.
Hey, Annie, don't let them take me, Annie!
Annie?
Coming.
One little tea cake ain't gonna ruin your appetite.
She's gone. My son and I don't get along. You don't know I'm your father. Nobody likes me. And supper's delayed. Some stick candy. One nibble of sweets can't do any harm.
Cut, cut! Now how am I gonna get her to eat her supper? You fill her up with that trash.
Tend to your work. Oh, you!
Miss Sullivan.
Here, at last. I've been on train so many days, I thought they must be backing up every time I dozed off.
I'm James Keller.
James? I had a brother, Jimmy. Are you Helen's?
I'm only half a brother. You're a governess?
Well, try.
You look like half a governess. Mrs. Keller, Miss Sullivan.
We've met every train for 2 days. I change the trains every time they stop. The man who sold me that ticket ought to be tied to the tracks.
You have a trunk, Miss Sullivan?
Yes. You didn't bring Helen. I was hoping you would.
No, she's home.
You live far from town, Mrs. Keller?
Oh, only a mile.
Well, I suppose I can wait one more mile, but don't be surprised if I get out to push the horse.
Helen's waiting for you, too. There's been such a bustle in the house, she's expecting something, heaven knows what. I expected a desiccated spinster. You're very young.
You should have seen me when I left Boston. I got much older on this trip.
I mean, to teach anyone as difficult as Helen.
I mean to try. They can't put you in jail for trying.
Is it possible, even, to teach a deaf, blind child half of what an ordinary child learns?
Half?
A tenth.
No. Dr. Howe did wonders, but an ordinary child? No. Never. But then I thought when I was going over his reports, he never treated them like ordinary children or like eggs everyone was afraid would break.
May I ask how old you are?
Well, I'm not in my teens, you know. I'm 20.
All of 20.
Mrs. Keller, don't lose heart just because I'm not on my last legs. I have 3 big advantages over Dr. Howe that money couldn't buy for you. One is his work behind me. I've read every word he wrote about it, and he wasn't exactly what you call a man of few words. Another is to be young. I've got energy to do anything. And the third is I've been young.
Advantages.
Well, some have the luck of the Irish, some do not.
What will you try to teach her first?
First, last, and in between, language.
Language.
Language is to the mind more than light is to the eye. Dr. Howe said that.
Language? We can't get through to teach her to sit still. You are young, despite your years, to have such confidence. Do you inside?
No. To tell you the truth, I'm as shaky inside as a baby's rattle.
Well, don't be. We'll do all we can to help and to make you feel at home. Don't think of us as strangers, Miss Annie.
Oh, strangers aren't so strange to me. I've known them all my life.
Miss Sullivan. I'll take it you all, Miss Sullivan.
Oh, my husband, Miss Annie, Captain Keller.
Oh, how do you do, Captain?
A pleasure to see you at last. I trust you had an agreeable journey.
Oh, I had several. When did this country get so big?
Oh, where would you like the trunk, Father?
Where Miss Sullivan can get at it, I imagine.
Yes, please. Where's Helen?
In the hall. Jimmy?
Oh, we put you in the upstairs corner room, Miss Annie. If there's any breeze at all this summer, you'll feel it.
And the suitcase.
I'll take the suitcase, thanks.
Not at all. I have it, Miss Sullivan.
I like it.
I couldn't think of it, Miss Sullivan. You'll find in the South with few women as the flowers of civilization.
Something in it for Helen! Thank you. When do I see her?
Oh, there's Helen.
Thank you.
She's very rough, Katie.
I like her.
Certainly, we're a peculiar kind of young woman in the North. How old is she?
Oh, well, she's not in her teens, you know.
She's only a child. But what's her family like shipping her off alone this far?
I couldn't learn. She's very close-mouthed about some things.
Why does she wear those glasses? I like to see a person's eyes when I talk.
Oh, for the sun. She was blind.
Blind?
She's had 9 operations on her eyes, one just before she left.
Blind? Good heavens! Do they expect one blind child to teach another? Has she experience, at least? How long did she teach there?
She was a pupil.
Katie, this is her first position?
She was valedictorian.
Here's a house full of grown-ups can't cope with a child. How can an inexperienced, half-blind, Yankee schoolgirl manager?
Great improvement. Now we have 2 then to look after.
You look after those strawberry plants!
Nothing I say is right.
Why say anything? Don't be long, Captain. We'll have supper right away.
Finding out she's ticklish. She is. What is it, a game?
An alphabet.
Alphabet?
For the deaf. Oh, how bright she is.
You think she knows what she's doing? She imitates everything.
Yes, she's a bright little monkey, all right.
Thank you.
Jimmy, will you call your father?
Certainly. Oh, father! Supper!
No need to shout. I've been cooling my heels for an hour. Sit down.
Certainly.
Ginny!
Yes, Captain.
Richard went directly to sleep, Ginny.
Oh, yes, that babe's an angel.
And Helen had a good supper?
I don't know, Miss Kate. Somehow, she didn't have quite an appetite tonight.
Oh, dear.
Couldn't say the same for myself. I'm famished. Katie, you please.
But where is Miss Abby?
In her room.
In her room? Doesn't she know hot food must be eaten hot? Go bring her down at once, Jimmy.
Certainly. I'll get a ladder.
What?
I'll need a ladder. Shouldn't take me too long.
That shouldn't take you that long.
Jimmy, do as I say. Go upstairs at once and tell Miss Sullivan supper is getting cold.
She's locked in her room.
What on earth are you talking?
Helen locked her in and made off with the key.
And you sit here and say nothing?
Well, everyone's been telling me not to say anything.
Jenny, look out the back for Helen. See if she has that key.
Yes, Miss Kate.
She's out by the pump! Miss Sullivan, are you in there? Is there no key on your side?
Well, if there was a key in here, I wouldn't be in here. Helen took it. The only thing on my side is me.
Miss Sullivan, not in the house 10 minutes. I don't see how you managed it.
And even I'm not on my side.
Ginny! Put that meat back in the oven.
She has no key.
She must have the key. Have you searched in her pockets?
Yes, she doesn't have it.
Peter, she must have the key.
Would you prefer to search her yourself, Captain?
No, I would not prefer to search her. She almost took my kneecap off this evening when... Take that ladder back!
Certainly.
She could have hidden the key.
Where?
Anywhere, under a rock, in the flower beds, in the grass.
Oh, I can't plow up the entire grounds to find a missing key. Jimmy!
Sir!
Bring me the ladder!
Certainly.
What is Mildred doing up?
Captain, woke her up, ma'am. All that hollering.
Miss Sullivan!
Yes?
Come out!
I don't see how I can. There isn't room.
I intend to carry you. Climb onto my shoulder and hold tight.
No, that's very chivalrous of you, but really, I prefer...
Miss Sullivan, follow instructions. I will not have you also tumbling out of our windows. I hope this is not sample what we may expect from you in the way of simplifying the work of looking after Helen.
Captain Keller, I am perfectly able to go down a ladder under my
own... I doubt that, Miss Sullivan. Simply hold on to my neck. My neck, Miss Sullivan!
Sorry to inconvenience you this way.
No inconvenience. Other than having that door taken down and lock replaced, we failed to find that key.
Oh, I'll look everywhere for it.
Oh, thank you. Do not look in any rooms that can be locked. There.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Go. Go back to your work. What are you looking at here? There's nothing here to look at. Now can we have supper like other people?
Jenny, serve supper. I'll put Mildred to sleep.
Might as well leave the L-A-D-D. E-R.
I'm so easily gotten rid of? You have a thing or two to learn first. I have nothing else to do. And nowhere to go.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Ladies Geyer Auxiliary will now be serving light refreshments upstairs.
Thank you. Vicky, where are you sitting at, babe? Huh?
Yep.
I'm sitting on the right side, and then she left.
Short
and hair. Of course, I had to ask so that wouldn't work for me.
Control her. The greatest problem I have is how to discipline her without breaking her spirit. But I shall insist on ink has a name. Out of the soup. These blots are her handiwork. Bad girl. Good girl. Very.
To her.
Oh, I was just making conversation, saying it was embroidery.
But does that mean that to her?
No, she won't know what spelling is till she knows what a word is.
Yet you keep spelling to her. Why?
I like to hear myself talk.
Yeah. The captain says
it's like smelling to the fence post.
It's dusty now.
Is it?
No, it's how I watch you talk to Mildred.
Mildred.
Any baby. Gibberish, grown-up gibberish, baby talk gibberish. Do they understand one word of it to start? Somehow, they begin to. If they hear it, I'm letting Helen hear it.
Other children are not impaired.
There's nothing impaired in that head. Works like a mouse trap.
But after a child hears how many words, Miss Annie? A million?
I guess no mother's ever minded enough to count.
What did she spell?
I spelt card. She spelt cake. No. It's still a finger game to her, no meaning. What she has to learn first is that things have names.
And when will she learn?
Maybe after a million and one words?
I should like to learn those letters, Miss Annie.
I'll teach you tomorrow morning. That makes only half a million each.
It's her bedtime.
Why does she get a reward for stabbing me?
Well, we catch our flies with honey, I'm afraid. We haven't the heart for much else, and other times she simply cannot be compelled.
Yes, I'm the same way myself.
Oh, have some pity in you. Now, kindly, do as I say.
What? Let pity! For this tyrant! The whole house turns on her wits. Is there anything she wants she doesn't get? I'll tell you what I pity. That the sun will rise and set for her all her life, and every day you're telling her it will. What good will your pity do her when you're under the strawberries, Captain Keller?
Hey, for the love of heaven, will you...
Miss Annie, please, I don't think it serves to lose...
It does you good. That's all. It's easier to feel sorry for her than to teach her anything better, isn't it?
I'll fail to see where you have taught her anything yet, Miss Sullivan.
I'll begin this minute if you'll leave the room, Captain. Everyone, please.
Miss Sullivan, you are here as a paid teacher. Nothing more. And not a lecture.
I can't unteach her 6 years of pity if you can't stand up to one tantrum. Old stonewall, indeed. Mrs. Keller, you promised me help.
Indeed, I did. We truly want to.
Then leave me alone with her. No, now.
Can I speak to you outside, please? This moment.
Thank you.
cannot wait out here a minute longer, Kate. Why, this could go on all afternoon, too.
I'll tell the captain you called.
You hear what Miss Kate say? Never you mind what's going on here. Run along, tend to your business.
Shoo! Say what you like, Kate, but that child is a Keller. And need I remind you that all the Kellers are cousins to General Robert E. Lee. Now, I don't know who that girl is. Only Sullivan's I've heard of, and from Boston, too. And trust me, I wouldn't lock her up with any of that kind. Is that man John L.?
You give me her, Miss Kate. I'll sneak her in back to her crib.
This child never gives me a minute's worry.
Oh, yes. This one's an angel of family. No doubt about it.
Deaf, mute woman. Can nothing be done to disinter this human soul? The whole neighborhood would rush to save this woman if she were buried alive by the caving in of a pit and labor with zeal until she were dug out. Now, if there were one who had as much patience as zeal, he might awaken her to a consciousness of her immortal.
Annie, you there?
Hush.
Annie, what's that noise?
Just a clock, Jenny.
Where are they pushing it? Annie, does it hurt to be dead?
Now it's schools!
There are schools outside.
Schools! We're reaching climbers! Where's the view? To read! To read and write! There are schools outside! Where is there?
Little girl, I must tell you, your brother will be going on a journey soon.
Annie!
Goodbye, Annie! I'll
write me when you learn how.
Desperately for her in the pit, and is the life of the soul of less import than that of the body?
Yeah, I will not have it. Well, now, you did not see when that girl after supper tonight went to look for Helen in her room?
No.
The child practically climbed out of her window to escape from her. What kind of teacher is she? Now, I thought I had seen her at her worst this morning, shouting at me. But I come home to find the entire house disorganized by all her. Helen won't stay one second in the same room. Won't let herself be bathed or undressed or put to bed by her, or even by Jenny now. And the end result is that you have to do more for the child than before we hired this girl's services. From the moment she stepped off the train, she's been nothing but a burden. Incompetent. Impertinent. Ineffectual. Immodest.
She folded her napkin, Captain.
What?
Not ineffectual. She did fold her napkin.
What in heaven's name is so extraordinary about folding a napkin?
Well, it's more than you did, Captain.
Does Miss Sullivan propose to teach a deaf-blind pupil who won't let her even touch her?
I don't know.
The fact is, today she scuttled any chance she ever had of getting along with the child. If you can see any point or purpose to her staying on here any longer, it's more than
what I... What do you wish me to do?
I want you to give her notice.
I can't.
Well, then, if you won't, I must. Look, I simply will not have to. Miss Sullivan?
Captain Keller. Jenny said I'd find you both over here in the garden house. I thought maybe we should have a talk.
Yes. Well, come in. Katie.
Captain.
I wanted to make my position clear first to... Mrs. Keller in private. I have decided I am not satisfied. In fact, I'm deeply dissatisfied with the manner in which
you... Excuse me, is this little house ever in use?
In the hunting season, if you will give me your attention, Miss Sullivan, I have tried to make allowances for you because you come from a part of the country where people are... Women, I should say, come from who, well, for whom allowances must be made. I have decided, nevertheless, that is decided, Miss Sullivan, I find it difficult to talk through those glasses.
Oh, of course.
Why do you wear them? The sun has been down for an hour.
Any kind of light hurts my eyes.
Miss Sullivan, I have decided to give you another chance.
To do what?
To remain in our employ, but on two conditions. I'm not accustomed to rudeness in servants or women, and that is the first. If you are to stay, there must be a radical change of manner.
Whose?
Yours, young lady! Isn't all this... And the second is that you persuade me that there's the slightest hope of you teaching a child who flees from you now like the plague to anyone else she can find in the house.
There isn't.
What, Miss Annie?
It's hopeless here. I can't teach a child who runs away.
And do I understand you propose?
Well, if we all agree it's hopeless, the next question is what, Miss Annie?
I am not agreed. I think perhaps you underestimate Helen.
I think everybody else here does.
She didn't fold her napkin. She learned, she learns. Do you know she began talking when she was 6 months old? She could say, water. Oh, not really. Wawa. Wawa, but she meant water. She knew what it meant. And only 6 months old, I never saw a child more bright or outgoing. It's still in her somewhere, isn't it? You should have seen her before her illness. Such a good-tempered child.
She's changed.
Miss Annie, put up with it and with us.
Us!
Please. Like the lost lamb in the parable, I love her all the more.
Mrs. Keller, I don't think Helen's greatest handicap is deafness or blindness. I think it's your love and pity.
Now, what does that mean?
All of you here are so sorry for her. You've kept her like a pet. Why, even a dog, you housebreak. It's no wonder she won't let me come near her. It's useless for me to try to teach her language or anything else here. I might as well.
Miss Annie, before you came, we spoke of putting her in an asylum.
What kind of asylum?
For mental defectives.
I visited there. I can't tell you what I saw. People like animals or rats in the hallways. What else are we to do if you give up?
Give up?
You said it was hopeless.
Here. Give up what? I only today saw what has to be done to begin. I want complete charge of her.
You already have that. But it has resulted in...
No, I mean day and night. She has to be dependent on me.
For what?
Everything. But the food she eats, the clothes she wears fresh, air, yes, whatever her body needs is a primer to teach her out of. It's the only way. One who lets her have it should be her teacher. Not someone who loves her. You all have so many feelings, they fall over each other like feet. You won't use your chances, and you won't let me.
But if she runs from you to us...
Yes, that's the point. I'll have to live with her somewhere else.
What?
Till she learns to depend on and listen to me.
For how long?
As long as it takes.
Miss Sullivan!
Captain Keller, it needs both your conditions. It's the one way I can get back in touch with Helen, and I don't see how I can be rude to you if you're not around to interfere with me.
And what is your intention if I say no? Pack the other half for home and abandon your charge to...
The asylum? I grew up in such an asylum. The state almshouse. Rats, why? My brother Jimmy and I used to play with the rats because we didn't have toys. Maybe you'd like to know what Helen will find there not on visiting days? One ward was full of the old women, crippled, blind, most of them dying, but even if what they had was catching, there was nowhere else to move them, and that's where they put us. There were younger ones across the hall, prostitutes, mostly with TB and epileptic fits, a couple of the kind who keep after other girls, especially young ones, and some insane. Some just had the DTs. The youngest were in another ward to have babies they didn't want. They started at 13, 14. They left afterwards, but the babies stayed, and we played with them too, though many of them had sores all over from diseases you're not supposed to talk about, but not many of them lived. The first year, we had 80. 70 died. The room Jimmy and I played in was the dead house where they keep the bodies until they could...
Oh, my dear.
Graves. No. No. It made me strong. But I don't think you need to send Helen there. She's strong enough. No. I have no conditions, Captain Keller.
Miss Annie.
Yes?
Where would you take Helen?
Oh... Italy?
What?
Can't have everything. How would this garden house do? Fix it up, bring Helen here after a long ride so she won't recognize it, and you can see her every day, if she doesn't know. Well,
is that all?
That's all.
Captain, with your permission?
Why must she depend on you for the food she eats?
I want control of it.
Why?
It's a way to reach her.
You intend to starve her into letting you... Gotcha.
She won't starve. She'll learn. I'll spare 11 more, Captain Keller. You never cut supplies.
This is hardly a war.
Well, it isn't love. A siege is a siege.
Miss Sullivan, do you like the child?
Do you?
You could have a servant here.
I'll have enough work without looking after a servant. But that boy Percy could sleep here, run errands.
We can let Percy sleep here, I think, Captain.
And some old furniture all our own?
Captain, do you think that home on bedstead of the bond would be too
big? I have not yet consented to Percy! Or to the house, or to the proposal, or to Miss Sullivan's staying on when I... Very well, I consent to everything. For 2 weeks, I'll give you 2 weeks in this place, and it will... Miracle if you get the child to tolerate you.
2 weeks?
came for money. A, the first of many, 26. I always wanted to live in a doll's house.
You don't let go of things easily, do you? How will you win her hand now in this place?
What? Do I know? I lost my temper and here we are.
No touching, no teaching, of course. You are bigger.
I'm not counting on force, I'm counting on her. That little imp is dying to know.
Know what?
Anything. Common God's creation. I'll have to use that appetite too.
Maybe she'll teach you.
Of course.
That she isn't. That there's such a thing as dullness of heart, acceptance, letting go. Sooner or later we all give up, don't we?
Maybe you all do. It's my idea of the original sin.
What is?
Giving up.
You won't open her. Why don't you just let her be? Have some pity on her for being what she is.
If I ever once thought like that, I'd be dead.
Oh, you will be. Why trouble? Or will you teach me?
Does she know where she is?
We brought her out in the country for 2 hours.
For all she knows, she could be in another town.
That's a sign for me.
I know. In 2 weeks.
Miss Annie, these 2 weeks, try to be very good to her. Please be very good to her.
I will.
I don't understand it. I had every intention of dismissing that girl, not setting her up like an empress.
Yes. What's her secret, sir?
Secret?
That enables her to get whatever she wants out of you when I can't.
She does not get anything she wants from me!
Don't.
Empton!
He's afraid. What does he want out of me?
My God. Don't you know? Everything you forgot when you forgot my mother.
What? One thing that girl's secret is not. She doesn't die one shot and disappear.
Captain,
she needs.
Why can't my son be? He can't bear me. You think I treat him as hard as this girl does? Ellen.
Perhaps you do.
But he has to learn some respect.
Do you like the child? How empty the house is tonight. No. No pity. I won't have it. On either of us.
Is it working? yeah, walk in front of him. When are you walking over here?
Oh, no worries.
Thank you.
Too restless. I can't sit to do it.
You should eat, my dear. It will be a long day waiting.
But it's been a short 2 weeks. Never thought life could be so noiseless. Went too much quicker for me.
C.A.
Well, the house has been practically normal, hasn't it?
Jimmy.
Is it wrong to enjoy a quiet breakfast? 5 years, you two seem to enjoy each other.
It could be even more noiseless, Jimmy, without your tongue running every minute. I've been trying not even to imagine
since
Captain, it's true. The 2 weeks have been long, quiet, all you say. But not short. Interment. W-A-T-E-R. It means this. W-A-T-E-R. This.
Only meant
if
you saw him in Zaboo.
Intentional,
it seems.
If and when you're a parent, Jimmy, you will understand what separation means. A mother loses a protector. You'll learn. We don't just keep our children safe. They keep us. There are, of course, all kinds of separation. Katie has lived with one kind for 5 years. And another is disappointment in a child.
I feel every day more and more inadequate.
Hey, I'm sorry. Open my mouth like that fairy tale of frogs to your mouth.
No, it has been better. For everyone. If only there were someone to help me. I need a teacher as much as Helen.
Hey, what does he want from me?
That's not the question, Jimmy. Stand up to the world. That comes first.
But the world is him.
Yes, and no one can do it for you.
Kate, at least we could. You be my friend?
I am. Interested, disjointed, where's discipline? What a dictionary, have to know how to spell it before you can look up how to spell it. Disciple, discipline. Discipline. Undisciplined.
What are you doing to your ass?
It's worse on my vanity. I'm learning to spell. It's like a surprise party. The most unexpected characters turn up.
You're not to overwork your eyes, Miss Annie.
Well, whatever I spell to Helen, I better spell right.
How serene she is.
She learned this stitch yesterday. Now I can't get her to stop. Such a little lady, she'd sooner starve than eat with her fingers.
You've done so much for her these 2 weeks, I would never have
enough. Obedience isn't enough. Well, she learned 2 nouns this morning. Key and water brings her up to 18 nouns and 3 verbs.
But not...
No, not, but they mean things. It's still a finger game, no meaning. Shall we play our finger game, Mrs. Keller?
How will she learn it?
It will come.
How?
How does a bird learn to fly? We're born to use words, like wings. It has to come.
How?
All right, I don't know how. I've done everything I can think of.
whatever she's learned here, keeping herself clean, knitting, stringing beads, meals, setting up exercises each morning. We climb trees, hunt eggs. Yesterday, a chick was born in her hands. All of it I spell. Everything we do, we never stop spelling. I go to bed with writer's cramp from talking so much.
And not to overwork your eyes, Miss Annie, I worry about you. You must rest.
Now? She spells back in her sleep. Her fingers make letters when she doesn't know. In her bones, those five fingers know, that hand aches to speak out, but something in her mind is asleep. How do I nudge that away? That's the one question.
With no answer.
Except keep at it, like this.
More time? Here?
Spell it.
Because I can't.
Spell it! If she ever learns, you'll have a lot to tell each other. Start now.
Miss Sullivan, on my way to the office. I brought Helen a playmate.
Outside, please, Captain Keller.
My dear child, the 2 weeks are up today. Surely you don't object to me.
They're not up till 6 o'clock.
Well, what difference can a fraction of one day make?
An agreement is an agreement. Now, you've been very good. I'm sure you can keep it up for a few more hours.
Miss Sullivan, you are a tyrant.
Likewise, I'm sure. Now, you can stand there and close the door if she comes.
I don't think you know how eager we are to have her back in our arms.
I do know, it's my main worry.
It's like expecting a new child in the house. She is so composed, so attractive. You've done wonders for her, Miss Sullivan.
Have I?
Well, if there's anything that you want in repayment from us, please tell us. It would be a privilege.
I just told Mrs. Keller I want more time.
Miss Annie.
Another week.
Well, wouldn't she miss us, though? I mean, what a wrench this unexplainable exile must be to her. Can you see it's not?
No, but...
doesn't she need affection too, Miss Annie?
She never shows me she does. She won't have any caressing.
But you're not her mother.
And what would another week accomplish? You've done more for her than we ever thought possible. You taught her constructive things to do.
I can't make any promises. All I can...
To act like and even look like a human child. So contented, manageable, cleaner.
Cleaner?
Well, we say cleanliness is next to...
Cleanliness is next to nothing. She has to learn that everything has its name, that words can be her eyes to everything in the world outside her and inside, too. What is she without words? With them, she can think, have ideas, be reached. There's not a thought or fact in the world it can't be hers. You publish a newspaper, Captain Keller. Do I have to tell you what words are?
Miss Sullivan.
And she has them already. 18 nouns and 3 verbs. I can only time to push one of them into her mind. One. And everything under the sun will follow. Don't you see that everything she's learned here is only clearing the way for that? I can't risk her unlearning it. Give me more time alone with her. Another week.
What is she spelling?
Water?
Teaching a dog to spell. The dog doesn't know what she means. Any more than she knows what you mean, Miss Sullivan. I think you ask too much of her. And of yourself. I may not have meant Helen to have the eyes you speak of.
I mean her too.
What is it to you? You make her see how we indulge her for our sake. Is the opposite true for you?
Happily.
An agreement is an agreement.
Mrs. Keller,
I want her back.
I'll send you over to help you back.
Not until 6 o'clock. I have until 6 o'clock.
6 o'clock.
dog. Dog. Tell you. Not a soul in the world knows how to tell you, Helen. Helen. Yes. What's it to me? Give them back their child. Dog. Both housebroken. Everyone's satisfied. But me. And you. Reach. Reach. I wanted to teach you everything the earth is full of, Helen. Everything that's ours for a wink, and then it's gone. And what we are on it, the light we bring to it and leave behind in words. Why, you can see 5,000 years back in a light of words. Everything we think, feel, know, and share in words. So not a soul is in darkness or dumbness, even in the grave. And I know. I know one word, and I can put the world in your hand. And whatever it is to me, I won't take less. How do I tell you this? This means a word, and the word means this thing, wool. Or that this, S-T-O-O-L, means this.
Let her come!
Done with. Why not let it stay buried?
I think God wants only a resurrection.
What?
Forever and ever, forever and ever, forever and ever and ever.
Miss Annie, I've been waiting to give you this.
What?
Your first month's salary. With many more to come. Trust. It doesn't express what we feel. It doesn't pay y'all debt for what you've done.
What have I done?
Taking a wild thing and giving us back a child.
I taught her one thing. No. Don't do this, don't do that.
It's more than all of us could in all the years we tried.
I wanted to teach her what language is. I wanted to teach her yes.
You will have time.
I know to do nothing but obey is no gift. Obedience without understanding is a blindness too. Is that all I've wished on her?
No, no.
I don't know what else to do. Except keep doing what I have done. Have faith that inside wait, like water underground. All I can do is keep on.
It's enough for us.
You can't help, Captain Keller.
Ah.
Even learning no has been at a cost of much trouble and pain. Don't undo it.
Why should we wish?
The world isn't an easy place for anyone. I don't want her to just obey, but to let her have her way in everything is a lie to her. I can't. And I don't even love her. She's not my child. You've got to stand between that lie and her.
We'll try.
Because I will. As long as you let me stay, that's one promise I'll keep.
Agreed. We've learned something too. Won't you come now to supper?
Yes. Why doesn't God pay his debts each month?
I beg your pardon.
Nothing. I always wondered how I could earn a living.
Oh, you do.
I really do. Now the question is, can I survive it?
May I?
Evening, General.
Will you say the grace, Jimmy?
Jacob was left alone and wrestled with the angel until the breaking of the day, and the hollow of Jacob's thigh was out of joint as he wrestled with him. And the angel said, "Let thee go, for the day breaketh." And Jacob said, "I will not let thee go, except thou bless me." Amen. Oh, Helen, you angel.
That is a very strange grace, James.
Who started the muffins in?
It's from a good book, isn't it?
Well, yes, of course it is. Didn't you know?
Yeah.
Then why ask?
I mean, it is from the good book, and therefore fit to grace.
Well, I don't know about that. Oh, Miss Annie. Oh. Thank you. I mean, there's lots of things from the good book I don't care to hear just before eating.
Well, Finn, since Jacob's thighs out of joint, and so is this pig.
Oh, I do declare, James.
Oh, pickles, Aunt Jo.
Oh, certainly so. You know my opinion of y'all pickles.
Oh, this is the end of them, I'm afraid. I didn't put up nearly enough to have some of this year. I intend to.
Reverend, look in the office today and clean his hands and stop bleeding. Poor Bill, he was out of joint. You know, all we could do was just.
Oh, I was suspected of those hands.
Of what?
I think they're papists, as he tried.
Oh, now, James, I do believe that you are trying to pull my lower extremity. The next thing you know will be. Oh,
play tug of war for her. Either give her to me or leave her. What do you wish to do?
She doesn't have to wear the napkin on her first night back, but she doesn't want
to. And ask outsiders not to interfere.
Outsiders, I am the child's aunt.
Who wants it so much, Miss Annie? Please, I've made all of Helen's favorite foods tonight.
It's a homecoming party, Miss Annie.
She's testing. You realize?
She's testing you.
Jimmy, be quiet. But now she's home. Naturally, she
and wants to see what will happen at your hands. I said it was my main worry. Is this what you promised me not half an hour ago? Mrs. Kelly, teaching her is bound to be painful. To everyone. I know it hurts to watch, but she'll live up to just what you demand of her, and no more.
She's testing you.
Jimmy.
I have an opinion. I think
no one wants to hear your opinion.
I want to hear it. Of course she's testing me. Let me keep her to what she's learned, and she'll go on learning from me. Take her out of my hands, and it all comes apart. Be bountiful. It's at her expense. Please. Pass me more of her favorite foods.
Take her, Miss Annie.
Thank you.
Miss Annie, I think you're in the difficulty now. Now, I'll keep her to what she's learned. You're quite right there. But I don't see that we need to send her from the table. After all, she's the guest of honor. Bring her plate back.
If she were a seeing child, none of you would...
Well, she's not. I think some compromise is called for. Bring her plate back, please. There. It's not unnatural. Most of us take some aversion to our teachers. Occasionally, another hand can smooth things out. Now, shall we start all over?
I think we started all over.
Treat her like a seeing child because I asked her to see. I expect it.
teacher. Teacher.